All right.
Oh. Ooh. Okay, hold on. All right, so this is a test kind of stream, but I'm going to be playing a game. There's going to be some delay in the microphone with the game, so please excuse that. I'm having a kind of a different setup, not entirely, but it's just a little different, so if my voice sounds a little weird or if anything sounds a little off, it's because I'm trying to do something new. I just hope that, yeah, I could probably talk like this. Yeah, so there's going to be a little bit of a delay. It's about like a half, about a second, maybe a second and a half. It's going to be kind of a little weird, but hopefully it's not too terrible while I'm doing this recording. I don't know how much of Dusty Gulch I'm going to record, but I'm going to hope to do it all in one swoop. Oh no, Tubba Blubba. Also, like, casually watching Dragon Ball Z. Just a recording I found. Gotta use the main power. Gonna eat ya. Yeah, it's not bad. Because I had to... Basically, I was having the hardest time trying to figure out how to have a proper setup with my microphone. What I did was, I had to go get a piece of wood, and I cut it in a way so that it can be held up. It's hard for me to explain this, but I have this table in my room. I made it a long time ago, but it serves as kind of a, like, it can be a chest, the table, so you can use it for shit. But what's super nice about it, oh, I got him. But yeah, what's nice about it is the microphone, I couldn't get it to sit right, you know, so I couldn't, you know, have it stand up, so I had to, like, cut up these pieces of wood, which I didn't know that the place I went to actually had, like, a place you can, like, cut wood there for free, so I used that, like, I abused the shit out of that, and it wasn't even a lot, but I was able to cut the piece I needed to. And now I have a, like, kind of a makeshift stand, kind of. And it works out pretty well. Oh god, there's a lot of guys. Knock you out of the sky. There's so many of you, why? I can damage them a little bit. This guy hasn't even been touched. You know, it's kind of nice. I'm kind of doing a different strategy in this playthrough. I'm upgrading my badge points more than I am of my, my other stuff, and it kind of goes a long way. Because if you're not taking damage from these guys, you can, like, kind of dish out damage back on them. That's kind of neat. I've never actually been able to handle these guys before like that, so, oh my god. I always have too much shit around this time. Look at all these health items I have. Get rid of that. Okay, yeah, item place I can, like, drop shit off at. I don't even know. No, I don't even want to go back. We're just going to keep going forward. That repel gel actually is really useful. That was beautiful. Ah, shit. Well, that's not helpful. Oh my god, that's... Wow, Jesus. That's a lot of bullshit. Ugh. Oh, here comes the boom. This looks like it's about to be peaceful. No violence here. Yeah, there's... Yeah, that was like literally Explosion City. Also, welcome. I was just actually talking about how... So, my microphone is going to be a little bit out of sync. It's because of my setup being kind of old. But, oh my god, what is with all these homies just in the sky? But I actually did some woodworking today. And I had to do a makeshift, had to make a makeshift microphone stand, you know, to do the streaming and how I want to make it, you know, but, it's really hard for me to explain it, but, like, I have my second monitor set up. Oh, crap, I forgot the delay. I have my second monitor set up, or my third monitor, which is like a touchscreen. And it has all my stream stuff so I can, like, kind of touch it with my stuff. And then I had the problem of trying to figure out where to mount my microphone because I had the thing mounted on my table, like, on the side of it. But then I didn't want to screw more shit into my... I didn't want to screw more shit into my table, so I... went to Menards and I went over to the wood section. I tried to find the smallest piece of wood I could find so I could maybe like cut it into something. And then they were like, well, you know, we have like a cutter, we can have a cutting station in the back. So I was able to use their cutting station, cut the pieces I needed, make the thing I needed to make. Now I have the microphone like comfortably positioned in a spot where it's like not even in the... Oh my god, that's awful. It's in a position that's comfortable, so I can, like, keep it there without having to, like, worry about... Like, I don't have to move anything around. I can just kind of pull the shit out. It's a little delayed, and that has to do with the stuff I'm using. It's kind of older, but as long as it keeps working, everything should be okay. But, oh yeah, going back to what you were saying... Oh, gotta get this... yeah, you need to get this game. This is a fucking good game. I was talking about how this is kind of an underutilized kind of a game, you know. But here, eat the apple. That sounds like a great thing. Hey, no need to upgrade more if it's working. That's just it. Well, the thing is, okay, so I have two recording software systems. I have two Elgatos. I have 60HD, which is the one that's in my current room. I use that to record my VHS tapes. It's really good at it, believe it or not. And then I have this one. The one that you're currently seeing is just a standard Elgato, like, it's like just a standard Elgato game capture, like the one that they made from like the mid-2000s or whatever. But what's nice about it is that it has... Oh, jeez. It has like three. Oh my god, why is there so many? Okay, alright. I'm choosing violence. Here we go, choosing violence. But basically, it has like three options that you can play games through. So unlike the 60HD, which only has HDMI, and you have to like get an upscaler in order to connect it to the, in order to connect like, you know, AV games like the N64, basically any of the older games, you'd have to use something like that. I'm gonna upgrade my HP one more time. You'd have to upgrade all that shit. But with the older one, it can do component, composite, and HDMI all at the same time. And it's a little bit not better quality, but it's like I can play like all of my games, which is amazing. And I've never had this kind of like accessibility before. But the fact that I can just kind of pop them on, I can turn, like I'm playing an N64, I could turn on the PlayStation 2, and then I can go to the Xbox 360 and I can turn that on and play that through the component. It's really convenient, and I really like that. But yeah, I was just, why am I, oh god, that's right, I'm on the wrong partner. I think I played this one. My god. We're just gonna take him out. Oh, I ain't plugging my Intellivision to my 60HD. Need that cable converter. Yeah, well, so the thing is that my Atari actually can connect through the coax on my CRT, because I'm playing this on an original CRT, and it's outputting out of it into the game capture, because it's got an output on it, and it's really fucking convenient. The only inconvenience is that the TV has to be on in order for it to, you know, the TV has to be on in order for it to display anything. So if I turn it off, it'll shut everything down. But yeah, I'm playing on like a 36-inch bulb, a Sony right now, which I hope to have for a really long time. It's a good monitor. I've had it for a while. It's a beast. Thing weighs like almost 200 pounds. God, okay, I gotta switch out this guy. No, not good. Why is it that every time I fight these guys, they have like two more than, forget it, I'm complaining. I'm just gonna blow them up. Like that. And then, piss. It's whatever, it's fine, I don't care. We're gonna take out the guys that can hurt me. Oh my god. I'm feeling like a dweeb right now. I gotta do strategy. Also, did you see the new game? Did you see the new Mario RPG, Brothership? So, I got opinions about that. Like, I'm not gonna say it's a bad game, but I'm just kind of confused. I'm mixed feelings. I don't know if you are yourself, but I think it's very interesting that, you know, you can basically dismantle the entire Mario RPG, like, system that you created, and then, like, you're like, we're gonna bring it back for pranks, you know? I'm just complaining, but Alpha Dream is kind of gone, but, you know, I don't know if it's intelligent systems that's taken over, which if they did, they might do a good job, but for the most part, I'm kind of skeptical right now. The game looks good, but I'm kind of skeptical. Oh, I fucking hate this part. So, I gotta, like, I don't know if you've ever played this game, but there's like this part where you gotta like, I'm hitting the wrong button. You gotta like dodge these ghosts. No idea, I couldn't tell you. Yeah, it's like, it says they haven't announced who's making the game, but hopefully, we're gonna prank this guy. Hopefully it's some good developers, they normally do. I have played this game, I think. Yeah, it's a good game. I remember renting it and then buying it. I got it for Christmas, I think. But here, we're gonna prank this guy. Check out this prank. We just pranked him. Well, this is gonna suck. Because they... really matter. We just pranked him, and then we're gonna get this guy. Guy isn't gonna get hurt because he's not touching me. Damn, that sucks. That is no bueno. Ugh. We gotta rake in the freaking points. The Paper Mario games are all good. Did you see the Nintendo Direct? Yeah, I did. I was looking at the Brothership. There was a few other games, but I think I was just mostly looking at the Brothership. Christ. That's good. I'm getting so good with that. God, fuck. There's so many of them. I should switch out to another ability. I just pranked him. I think I'm gonna have to switch to the multi-bounce. Also, just to make sure, I'm coming in okay, right? Oh, you're back in there? Yeah, I'm still chilling in the state still. Whoa. Yeah, you sound great. Okay, cool. Is the game coming in good too? I just need to make sure. That's good, but yeah. No, that's cool that you're in the Fox Valley, though. Yeah. For the most part, I've just been chilling around. Kind of up and around, but not, like, really going too many different places. But if you are in the Fox Valley, we should definitely hang out sometime. God, see, look at that. Been working my way back home, aren't we all, honestly? Sometimes you just need to come back to really figure out what you want to do. Thank you. Yeah, it's just inconvenient right now, you know? Like, I don't have an ability that can block their attacks. Like, I'm constantly taking damage. And I was just bragging about how good my ability... I'm not even using that power jump, so I should use something. Could use the Quake Hammer. That is 2 FP. So I would be using 8 FP, taking out a shit ton of people. Dodge Master helps me. Makes the action command work more frequently. That's good. I will try to remember to DM you on Twitch, get you my number and whatnot. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it'd be cool. Always have fun things to do, that's for sure. This item, just side note, this badge is really fucking good. It helps you a lot. You get it in like some star thing. You know what? We're just gonna roll with that. We're gonna roll with that and see where it takes us. Hey, buddy. Alright, and... body slam this guy. Zap Tap is good because... So, it not only, if it's a physical attack, it can deal damage to the opponent, it can also stop attacks that will be, like, continuous, if that makes sense. So, like, there can be attacks where you have to, like, block it every time, but if you have the Zap Tap, you'll take the damage the first hit, but then it'll stop their attack completely. There's a couple of bosses where... You need, where if you don't have this badge, it's like almost near impossible to beat them. Almost near impossible. I'm just not good. Alright, we gotta pogo jump our way down here. I think there's a thing I can break. Not sure. Oh, you mother... Wait, can I dodge it? No! 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 Fuck! Piss. I messed it up. Oh my god, blow my... I always mess it up. I always do that once. They'll throw us out of the... Shut the fuck up. You think I don't know that? You think I'm not a jackass enough? Christ. Just spin. Yeah, I almost forgot. Ugh, Christ. Just spin your way back. I have the mega spin so I can like just spin my way over. Alright, we're gonna look at him doing a little twirly twirl. Alright, we're gonna do that again. Yeah, there we go. Alright, we're gonna upgrade our party member. We don't need that. We'll upgrade Bao. It's like the Zelda. It literally is, except you can't really dodge it. That's the thing. You have to use this character's ability. So like here, if you go up and it comes down, you use that and it disappears. But if you go out of its range box, it'll stop following you. So it just becomes kind of worthless. But if you have, I have like a speedy zoom kind of spin thing. God, it's crazy. Sorry to sidetrack again. In this room, I remember playing on a projector monitor, like a projection screen TV, one of those big like 50 inch ones. And I remember I could not see a single goddamn thing in this room. And somehow, like, my TV picks it up really good. It looks way better. It looks kind of like what it looks like on the stream. Yeah, I won't fight him. Yeah, he's just telling me that I gotta give Hot Tub of Lava a heart attack. I gotta punch him right in his heart. Anyway, there's a key, I think, up there. And I'm not saying here in Spanish. Actually, take me out of here. Do I have one of the keys? I'm not even sure. I'm gonna be honest with you. Don't have one. Okay, I think it might be over there. Unless I... Nope. Get away from me. I don't know why you're following me. Oh my god. I don't even know what those things are supposed to be. Like, they're like a weird looking ghost. Is there anything in here? No, I already was in here. Great, I'm getting freaking Alzheimer's remembering this level. I can't even remember it. Didn't I go down here? God. What did I just end your sleep for a bit? There's gonna be a room that's full of these guys, and we're gonna harvest them, and that should give us enough to level up. We're gonna level up our badge points again. Or should we level up the flower points? We should level them up one more time so that we can get a little bit better leverage and start pile drive. Oh, fuck. I literally just walked right into that. Okay, here. This is actually a perfect opportunity to use this. We'll do that. And then we'll do this. Yeah! That's nice. There's that key. So, I should mention, now that we have the ground pound, we can get more star spirits. Or, excuse me, star pieces. And that entire... And, like, that's basically floor panels. We can just flip them over. Going to be AFK for a moment. Going to run through the post-work ritual. You're good, dude. Fuck. Actually, take me out of here. I'm taking a warp. Get me out of here. Get me out of here.
Mario, if they throw us out, we'll die.
Yeah, that's Randy, baby. Get out. We can go over here. Oh, I got him? Okay. There we go. We'll use that. And... we'll do that. Wait, what? That didn't do anything. Oh, no. Oh, no. So it's exactly 8. That's wild. That is way too extra. You gotta be quicker on the draw, buddy. I can use that. I'll use that. It'll save me some flower points. Perfect.
taking them out. I messed it up. Well,
yeah, it's cool because the refund, that's the item thing, it allows you to, we're harvesting as many as we can. Oh my god, look at all these homies. Okay, we gotta do a, that's it, right there. And then we gotta hit him with the quake. Quake hammer. Nice! That was way too quick. Oh my god. Man, it's kind of annoying. Unsuspecting criminals. All right. We could take these guys out. Yeah. I don't even know why I still have the zap tap up. I think I just have it because I'm just too lazy to get it taken off. I think it's this one. Or I know one of these allows me to get back up here. Yeah. So it kind of warps me up there, and I can get this thing. The D down jump. And go back here. Is there a... God, why do they have these guys like littered all over the place? Oh my. I'd rather deal with you. Okay, I'm gonna put you all to sleep. Yeah, I can do that. That I can afford to do that, because I'm gonna level up anyway. Dude, how did you not fall asleep? You guys love to fall asleep. You guys literally die for sleep. I hope you enjoyed that, because that's the last thing you're... Okay, I need to drink something. Fine. There. This is fine. There we go. More badge. Nice. Ah. Oh, that worked. That worked out for me. That's right. Can I? I forgot. I can actually, I think I can actually fall through this. Right? Yeah, right here. So I can get that. And then I can warp my way up to the next... I can get myself back to the stage. That's cool. Oh man, I can just... Okay, we can just do that then, I guess. Screw it. Right. Let's see what I can do for badges. D down pound. I don't really need a D down pound. I don't really need a power smash. Don't really need a deep focus. Power rush. Spike shield. I don't need it now. I really don't have anything, honestly. A hammer throw, power bounce. Same. I guess in the meantime, I can just keep it on the FP plus, you know? I'll take it off when I need to. God, why? There's so many of them. God, piss. There's so many of them, no reason. Gotta get all those coins. You know, I don't know if this was intentional, but it feels like the levels get nicer the higher you get up. But maybe it's not. Maybe it's just me. Oh, fuck.
What's this? Something smells fishy. Ooh.
Let's go head to head.
There we go. Is he coming? There he is. Oh, this is a good one. Here comes the trick. We're gonna just run through it. This is that room I was talking about. Run. Just run. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Bob and weave. Now we play the sniping game. Wait, what? I was gonna say, how did that not hit anybody? So some of these are gonna be one, and then there's gonna be some that are like a bunch of them. So we're just gonna hopefully take out the ones that are just the ones, and that'll be easy. But this is a good spot for star points. Oh my god, but I'm gonna lose the coins. Oh, here's the one with the bunch. Okay. You know the drill. We're gonna bomb them, and then we're gonna slice them in dice. I don't have any. I always mess this up. Good thing I have maple syrup. Let's quake them. We're still getting a lot of star points out of them, like two. We can work with this. Still at this part. Yeah, we're getting close. We're getting close to meeting the boss, actually. But we're just kind of harvesting some star points right now. Because there's actually... I know this is going to sound weird. The boss in this level is kind of hard. He's got like one of the highest... he's got one of the highest HPs, and he can deliver the highest amount of damage. Even at the beginning of in this point of the game, it's really weird. But, so we gotta kinda get ourselves ready in a way. But it helps us out in the long run. Oh, jeez. I guess we're gonna... Alright, we're gonna blow him up. I have zero patience for him. Hit him with the quake hammer. That's all of them. Yeah, we got a lot of star points out of that, so that'll help us. And now we're gonna go back this way, and we're gonna go into this room. There's actually, it's kind of funny. Here, oh, see, we get, boom. All right. We actually got up here pretty quick, so we're on, I think, the third floor. It's kind of boss time. It's kind of complicated, so there's going to be something funny that happens. Basically, we're trying to figure out Tubba Blubba. If you fight him right now, you won't do any damage because he's invincible. You have to figure out what his weakness is. And in order for you to do that, you have to, like, sneak into his lair. This is him right now. So what's gonna happen is I have to run away from him, and I have to reach this windmill, and then you'll see what happens. Kinda funny. Mario, he's just kinda like... Time for some beauty rest. I have to run to the boss. I'll just leave. No. Oh. Hi there. So yeah, this key. Yes. A thief. Now we gotta haul ass. Whoa. Oh, here it comes. Yeah, it's like insane. Game even like kind of slows down because of it. Oh. I'm hauling ass, holy fuck. You can't even keep up. Yeah, you didn't even get to me. So they're gonna fight a guy who eats ghosts. Like, hello? Do they realize how crazy that sounds? Whatever. I need to figure out what would be the best course of action to take on the heart. What would be the best course of action? Yeah, I know. He smelled delicious. You smell delicious, ghosts. Get away. I don't want to deal with you, small fries. I mean, I could probably harvest them, but I really don't want to deal with it right now. Oh, no. All right, you guys want to rumble and tumble? I'll give you the rumble and tumble. Time to show them the business. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting because, like I said, Like I said, this next boss, well, this boss is kind of hard, and I'm going at it with a different strategy. So, but I got my best partner out. So this guy right here, Goombario, yeah. So he has an ability that is a mix between head bonk and charge, and if you do it correctly, okay, I'm gonna go to my badges, I'm gonna turn off Quake Hammer, I can do Shrink Stomp, which that'll help me. There's damage dodge, Speedy Spin, I can turn that off. We're gonna do that. All right, we're gonna do that. Ah. Literally do a cage match, no holds bars, no DQs. I also love these signs. It's like, no entry allowed, Mario enters. God, I can't jump far enough. Oh, that's swell. That's dandy. Well, at least I could take him out. I'm not even trying to fight these guys. And then it says, really, no entry allowed, Mario enters. Oh, thank God. Absolutely no entry allowed.
What do you think it possibly be, Mario?
All right, here it is. This is the weakness. Like, who the fuck are you? No, you did. No, you did, you bonehead. He's like apologizing for it. Whatever, dude. Mario just trips ass in here. Alright, so... how do I... so the first thing I need to do is I need to do this. There we go. Then we go to charge. Then I'm gonna do the repel gel. It'll give me a lot of money. And we're gonna keep charging Goombario. Yeah, good job, Chief. Keep charging, buddy. Shit. Okay. Drink stomp. Nice. Get another charge in. Damn. We're gonna do one more for the road. Ah. I lied, we're doing this is the one more. This and this. Yeah. Look at that damage. And then we're just gonna... how much health do I got? I got 16. How much? Alright. I gotta use honey syrup. And then once you beat that, you can fight Tubba Blubba, and he has like, I think like a 10 HP. You just, all you have to do is just punch him in the face and he's done. It's really funny. But that fight right there that you watch, that's like one of the hardest fights, honestly. You get like certain items and you can pull it off. But here, now I can like do this. And then this is it. And that's it. A69. That's kind of funny. Yeah, literally, that heart fight, like, he deals, like, some decent shit. Like, they'll deal, like, 6 damage, and you gotta kind of work around it. But once you beat him, it's supposed to be, like, you're on your last leg, so now you gotta fight the actual boss, but then it just, he's a wimp. He loses. And he didn't even digest the ghosts. And he's gone. Yeah, it's good. I should have just said no. Would have been funny. Alright, another chapter in the wing. The next one is kind of fun. I remember playing this one a lot during the weekends. I get a lot of pizza and eat when I play that level. But this power star is actually really useful. One of our more powerful ones. It can deal 7 attack damage to all enemies, no matter air, ground, it even penetrates their defenses. It's really a good star spirit. I use this one quite a bit, actually. It's basically a shooting star that isn't an item. It does a little bit better damage. I think this is probably the most useful star spirit. Oh, Mario, did you beat the Tubba Blubba? I don't give a crap, Peach. Peach, you don't even know. It's kind of it's weird when the shooting star is called Twink. It has a whole other meaning, it feels like. Oh, Twink. Come on. Alright, time to use the secret thing. Oh, this is the one where I use the secret pe- passageway, and then Bowser is there, I think. Sorry if I'm spoiling this. I played this game so many times. Bowser's like, ugh, Peach, how'd you get there? Even though he couldn't hear the goddamn loud ass. Stupid ass. Sliding door, and Cammy is blind as a bat. Can't see her ass from her elbow.
Your filthiness.
Well, this is the one where I gotta answer questions. He's gonna be like, oh, what does Mario hate? And I'm gonna be like, a shooting star? a pop soda? Bowser's like, Mario hates Mario? Can you put Shadow Mario? See, you need to put Mushroom. Thunder Rage. Super Soda. Yeah, Mario hates all those things. You know, you want to know something kind of funny? When I was younger and I first played this game, I picked the enemies because I wanted to fight some of the enemies. Like, I wanted to fight the Pokey again because I haven't fought it in a while. And then at that point I didn't fight it in a while. And then there was the Koopa Patroller, and I thought that was cool because I was like, oh, this would be the first time I could fight one of these guys. Because you only fight those guys in at the last level. So fighting it that early in the game is kind of funny. It's kind of funny fighting it that early. All right, Bowser. Yep, you're so full of yourself. You're so f***ing funny, dude. So funny, dude. Throw the princess back in her house. Oh, poor Twink. Wow, shocker.
Oh, this life force is getting stronger all the time.
Christ. Alright, yeah, you gotta get back to Star Haven, man. Cool. Well, that's it. That's the game. Or at least in that section. We gotta go. Which part? So, I know I'm gonna have to fight this the dumbass bird thing.
Be like, Mario, I'm ready to fight you now. Is he gonna be flying?
Yeah, I think he's gonna be flying. Thank you. We'll turn on the zap tap. No, we don't need the zap tap. I already have it on. Don't need the shrinks. I can turn the shrink stomp. Deep focus, FPS. Alright, let's go. This next fight I'm gonna have is probably gonna be the more impressive boss fight. Right here. He's like, I've been looking for you, Mario. And I think he's gonna be flying. Yeah. Hey, you think I can't jump up there, dude? Goddamn psychopath. You know the drill. We're gonna charge. Man, he just three? How does he do that much damage? I just feel out of place here. You remember this guy? Yeah, this guy constantly appears throughout the game, constantly trying to ass wipe you, and he's just a jerk. I like how there's that option where you can choose, like, I don't know who you are, man. Come on, head bonk him. Man, that did nothing. God, there we go. Oh, we're so close to leveling up, too. Good job, Mario. Let's see if we can get... We're gonna level up. We're gonna level up by hopefully running into some people. Cool. Is there any bad guys? That's what I was looking for. Please tell me I can fight these guys and they'll give me enough. Just need a few more enemies. This might work out. If they give me, like, what, 4 or 5? Sucks, it doesn't even reset the enemies. It's all good.
out of there.
We're gonna save. Yeah, this is when shit's getting stolen. We gotta do something about that.
This calculator.
He's like, oh, I'm a dumbass. The calculator is gone. And he's like, oh, the mailbox. Oh, the mailbag. So I gotta get that. How many star pieces do I have? I have 10. I have 10 star pieces. I'm gonna have more because of the... The hell out of here. Yeah, no worries. This is the society I live in. Everybody's just running amok. I am weird to point where I remember all of this as I see, but I played this on the Wii U back in 2015. That was almost a decade ago. Isn't it surreal? Like, I got the Wii U, I went to Shopko, and I bought it when it was still around. It's just kind of surreal. Not over here, I think it's over on the other side. I think. Yeah, I'm wrong. There it is. Oh, jeez. Oh. Oh, there's nothing in here. Okay, that's fine. Circuit City. For a Wii. Yeah. I went to the Walmart. I think it was in Marinette, I think, at the time. They had 20, and I managed to get one. The more damage Mario takes, the more coins he receives. That's kind of neat. Pretty lucky. Every once in a while. Happy Heart. Heart Finder. Money, money. Mario's jump and hammer powers by 1. That's a good one. I don't have any more, Chief. What is the combination to do payoff? More coins he receives. I remember sitting out in the cold and Trevor and my dad, dude, Trevor, goddamn. That's a person I haven't seen in a hot minute. Turn this on. Payoff. Zap Tap stays on. turn that off. Turn on the happy heart. There we go. And we'll see how that works. Yeah, I was wondering if he was continuing with his streaming and stuff. I'm glad that he's doing esports stuff too. That's really cool. Oh, what are you looking down? Okay, so this guy's talking about a thing in a dream where you run around a post and you do it like 3 times and it activates this sort of thing, but then it tells them that there was a person that had a dream about doing a ground pound in a room with a spinning roof in Toad Town. He's on the downbeat. Is that the name of his stream now? All right, so I'm just gonna cheat. Boom. Yeah, that's a nice item. Is it like a... Nice. A 4. Man, that's a lot. That's a 4 thing. Let's see. No, I'm probably not even gonna level up. But I've tried to find if he's online and, well, I've too many followed. I get ya. Oh, Shy Guy is in his... He took the dictionary. God. Freaking dumb pieces of garbage. Yeah, well, this is what I think of that. I'm gonna blow your head off. I'm not gonna sell anything to you, Mario. Okay, fine. I'll just kill you. Classic Mario, always resorting to violence to get what he wants. All right, Luigi, I'm gonna help you. You're welcome. Good job, Luigi. Alright, so what are some other things I can do? I can kind of bum around. Oh, I think I can do this. There was one. Damn it. Whatever. I think there's one over here. Yeah. Okay, so I think on that note, I am going to call it quits. We had a good time. The microphone worked out pretty good. It's holding up pretty good on that block I made. Thank you, for coming in as always. And talking with me as usual. I'm hoping I'll be able to stream a little bit more, especially with this setup. So it's looking pretty good. Here, let me get that set up right there. But once again, thank you for coming in. And as always, take her easy and see you next time.